Hi and welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial we will see example of abstract method and abstract class. Now as we know that whenever we do not want to provide implementation or definition of any functionality, we can just declare it as abstract. Or when we want a particular functionality to be present in all the subclasses mandatory, then we can declare that functionality as abstract in superclass. So what we are going to do is, we are going to create a class shape with one abstract method draw. Since we want draw method to be present in all the subclasses of class shape, then we will create different subclasses for shape class, that will be class circle, class rectangle and class triangle, and then we will create two subclasses for class triangle, class upper triangle and class lower triangle. So let's implement it. We will first create our main class. Let it be class test. This is the class which will have the main method. And now we will define our other classes. We will give class shape first. Class shape. Now here we will have one abstract method draw. Now as soon as we declare this method, we are getting error. Why? Because whenever a class has at least one abstract method, class needs to be declared as abstract. So we need to change the type of our class to abstract. Now we will give the subclasses for our shape class. The first subclass is class circle. Extends shape. Okay. Now here we are getting error, and the reason for that is because circle is the subclass of shape class and shape has one abstract method. So this subclass has two choices. Either it can add the unimplemented method or it can be declared again as abstract. For now we will select add unimplemented method, that is we are going to override the draw method. Now here we will add a message: drawing circle. Similarly, we will define our second subclass, class rectangle. Extends shape. Now here again we will override the draw method. We will add a message here as well: drawing rectangle. And then we will give our third class, class triangle. Extends shape. Now for this subclass we are not going to override the draw method, so the second choice left is we need to declare our class as abstract. So we will declare this class as abstract. Now we will create the subclasses for class triangle, and that need to override the draw method of shape class. So we will give class upper triangle. Extends triangle. Now here we need to override the draw method. We will add a message here: drawing upper triangle. Similarly, if I create one more subclass for triangle, then that also needs to override the draw method. Class lower triangle. Extends triangle. Okay. So here we again need to override the draw method. drawing lower triangle. Now we will code our main method. In this main method, we are going to provide instantiation and invocation of methods. Now here, suppose if I try to create instance of first class shape. So what is going to happen over here? We will get an error. Why? Because the shape class has been declared as abstract and abstract classes cannot be instantiated. So in our example, we cannot create instance of shape class as well as triangle class because both have been declared as abstract. So this is not permitted. We will create objects for remaining classes. Class circle. Then for class rectangle, class upper triangle, class lower triangle. Okay, now we will call the methods from these classes. C.draw, R.draw, U.draw, and L.draw. So now, when we will execute our code, we will get the draw method called from these classes. So let's execute the code and validate the output. Drawing circle, drawing rectangle, drawing upper triangle, and drawing lower triangle. Now let's take a quick recap of what we have learned. Whenever a class will have at least one abstract method, class needs to mandatory declared as abstract. When you create subclasses for abstract class, then all the subclasses should either override the abstract method or the subclass will be declared again as abstract. And you cannot instantiate any abstract class. Hope now the concept of abstract method and abstract class is clear to you. Thank you for watching this video.